to you from our GIS studios. I am Anitia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. Saint Lucia, along with many other global leaders, made a commitment to promote sustainable development by signing onto the Agenda 2030 for Sustainable Development, which has replaced the Millennium Development Goals, or MDGs, a more robust and enhanced set of goals that focuses on people, planet, prosperity, peace, and partnership. The agenda is made up of 17 sustainable development goals and 169 corresponding targets. Countries must now take ownership of SDGs and develop strategies. The United Nations developed the mainstreaming, acceleration, and policy support maps to guide countries in landing the SDGs into national development plans with technical expertise from the UN systems. Saint Lucia began engagement with the UNDP in 2016 with the aim of developing a SDGs roadmap for the countries. At the end of the engagement process, it is anticipated that there will be an SDG-integrated and risk-informed national development plan, the identification of development finance solution towards meeting targets, and a work plan for monitoring and evaluation of targets. Spearheaded by the Ministry of Education, Innovation, Gender Relations and Sustainable Development, the Education Quality Improvement Project, EQIP, is on stream. Funding for the project was secured from the Caribbean Development Bank through the Department of Economic Development, Transport and Civil Aviation. EQIP formed part of discussions at the termly meeting of school principals and officials of the Ministry of Education, Innovation, Gender Relations and Sustainable Development. One component of the EQIP is enhancing capacity to improve teacher quality, relevance of education, and instructional effectiveness across the education sector. This project also focuses on enhancing the provisions for special needs education in Saint Lucia. In fulfilling these objectives, short-term and degree-level continuing professional development training programs are provided for teachers. Among those opportunities is the undertaking of master's programs at the University of New Brunswick. The Government of Saint Lucia has received financing from the Caribbean Development Bank equivalent to $16,192,000 towards the cost of implementing the EQIP project. The Dental Services Unit of the Department of Health and Wellness launches the first ever Dental Comic Strip competition. This competition is launched as an oral health promotion campaign targeting young adults between the age of 18 to 35 years. It is meant to encourage young people to take charge of their life in a healthy and positive way, to have health as a priority as they plan for their future and begin to navigate through life, creating their own path to success. With the focus on oral health, young people will make better choices for their oral hygiene and understand that changes in their breath can impact not only on their life, but on persons around them. The unit wants the public to know that poor oral hygiene can be a symptom of disease or can set the stage for undesirous outcomes, especially in their social interactions. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.